Then I got it fired. My head match in my bed. You know I'm popping tags. Cause man, I got it swag. Man, I got it swag.
Hey, Owl Nation.
I'm Lucy.
And I'm Riley. Welcome back to OWDIP TV and our first official episode.
We are back and better than ever.
We're so excited to kick off the first official episode and show you guys what we have in store for you this year.
Hey, Riley, I really like your shirt.
Thanks. I actually got it from the studio. I have a lot of West gear.
I do too. Have you ever wondered how much Olathe West gear Principal Novacek has?
I cannot even imagine.
Why don't we ask Novi ourselves in our new segment, Notes with Novi.
Hey, Owls. My name's Kennedy.
And my name's Hannah.
And we're back with our new segment, Notes with
Novi.
And our first question for you is, how much West gear do you own?
I have a lot. I think at home I have 3 closets full. So if you are an XL and you need any Olathe West gear at all, I probably can hook you up with a shirt, pullover, whatever you might need. I got you.
Okay. Our second question is, why do the lunches overlap?
So the lunches need to overlap because we have to have lunch in one class period. So we have to overlap them between 5 and 10 minutes depending on the day. And that is in order to get everybody fed and back to class within 1 hour.
What's your least favorite part about Olathe West?
In the spring, you guys will see it. Every once in a while, we have some weird smells that seem to come out of the building. We don't know what causes them or why they come about when the weather changes. But sometimes it does smell like rotten eggs in the building. And we just kind of have to keep on trucking with it.
Yeah. So, Novacek, you know the hot topic this school year about the new cell phone policy. And someone asked, wouldn't YouTube for Music be more distracting because you have to pick a new song every 2 minutes?
Yeah, so we're working with technology on that. We want our students to be able to listen to music appropriately. And one of the things that we are trying to do is get YouTube Music unblocked. One of the things that I do is I'll use the video version and just put in Zach Bryan videos and play 30 Zach Bryan songs in a row. Just always make sure you keep it in the background when your teachers are teaching. You shouldn't be watching the videos. Make sure that you're being respectful of their time as well.
Thanks, Novacek. If you have any questions for Mr. Novacek, follow on us on the Instagram at OWDIPTVTheDub and submit your questions in our Google form in our bio.
Thanks for joining us with Notes with Novi.
See you next time, Owls.
Novi out.
Thanks, Novacek. I think all my questions were answered.
I hear Novacek was pretty good at football in high school.
Speaking of football, last Friday we played Shawnee Mission West. It was definitely a good win. We are so proud of our Owls on the field and for everyone showing up and supporting.
Looks like the Better West won that one.
Make sure to come out to our next football game tonight against Blue Valley West at CBAC. The theme is whiteout. Make sure to bring your white gear and your spirit.
Our state champion cross-country team is on the road to their 5-peat win.
Let's kick it to Liz and Tyler where they sat down with Coach Carbajo to hear more about it.
Here we go. I feel like we like to live off of the saying that pressure is a privilege, and that's kind of been what we've said from the start. If we were just a average team, there would not be any pressure on us. And so we like to create an environment where there is pressure put on us. So then when we get to the end of the season, that we're performing at a high level. And it's because of that pressure that has got us there. So
each year,
I would say it's pretty hard to lose people on the team just because for 4 years, our sport kind of goes year round and we get to spend a ton of time with each other. And so when we lose a graduating class, it's just hard for everyone because we've spent so much time with them. But the it is very fun to have the opportunity to build up the freshmen and give them the same experiences that everyone else who has graduated in our program. Just being able to give them that experience is a fun thing to do as coaches. But I also think that our leaders on our team find that very fun too, because they get to be that person for the younger kids that they had when they were younger. I would say that the state championship is in the back of our minds all the time, but we know that we aren't able to get to where we want to be at the end of the season if we don't take each meet seriously. And we kind of look at our program and the season as a big puzzle. And so every single meet, practice, all of those things have to fit perfectly in place for us to do the big thing at the end of the year. So, I would say that the theme is just to show up every day and work hard and have fun. Having fun is always the number one thing on our list. And we think that being successful and doing the things that are very hard to get us to where we want to be at the end of the season is super fun. And yes, the five in a row would be awesome. And I think that we have the people to do it. We just got to show up every day, work hard, and on the boys' side, we have the people to do it as well, and I'm just very excited for this season and excited to watch their hard work pay off.
Wow, that's awesome, girls. I don't know about you, but I feel pretty inspired.
Those are some wise words from Coach Carbajo.
Soccer has started off their season strong and was ranked second in the top 25 soccer rankings for preseason. Volleyball has a game tonight at Shawnee Mission South, and the theme is tie-dye. Check out our volleyball themes and come and show support. And a big good luck to tennis, golf, and gymnastics this season.
That was a lot of athletics that we just covered. We know how athletic our students are, but let's see how they would do in our new version of the Olympics, Owlympics.
Let's take it to Jameson and Luis.
Hey, Owls, welcome to the first round of Owlympics breakdancing.
Let's see which Owls take home the gold.
What is that? And you find out if you do that.
Basketball and track will take place to determine the Owlympic winning team.
I don't know about you, but I really liked Mr. Jones' dance moves.
No, I think Dr. V's dance moves were hard to top.
I still can't believe that they put breakdancing in the Olympics.
Personally, I think our students could be the new Olympians with the right coaching.
Speaking of coaching, Olathe West Coach Kenny has decided to join the staff this year in teaching English.
Let's take it to Sydney, Hope, and Cameron to learn more about our new staff member.
My name is Mr. Kinney, and I teach language arts. I didn't expect to use as much sarcasm as I'm able to get away with in language arts. They're pretty intense. They are definitely different from middle school. The pace is a little bit faster compared to what I was used to. The biggest difference is in middle school I did a lot of front loading and a lot of reteaching, while here at the high school level, from what I've experienced, it's pretty straight through. There's a lot of background knowledge that's already there. My favorite thing about Olathe West is the family feel. I really do enjoy walking around the halls and students smiling, saying hi, even if they don't know me.
Welcome to West, Coach Kenny.
We're so excited to welcome you to the Nest along with all of our other new staff members this year. Stay tuned for more interviews with the new staff.
Hey Lucy, did you see Kenny's cool new shoes?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, they were pretty cool. West is the best school and has the best shoe game.
To prove it, we went around the halls to show you guys some of the coolest kicks we could find.
Hey, Owls, it's Riley.
And Reese.
And today we're going to be seeing who has the best shoe game here at West.
Let's go.
Who am I here with?
Mr. Novacek.
And can you tell us a little bit about your shoes?
Yeah, actually, Miss Black had a pair of them, and I said that I liked them. And she's like, oh, you should order them, because she orders a lot of shoes off of StockX. If you see Miss Black, she's always wearing StockX shoes. And she's like, oh, I can look. Here's your size. And I said, yeah, I don't know if I want them. And then the next thing I knew, they showed up and she had ordered them. So then I owed her $120.
Hey, well, I like them.
Yeah, she also talked to Mr. Smith's getting a pair too. So he'll be.
Oh, you'll all be matching.
Yeah, he'll be wearing them soon.
I love it.
Who am I here with?
Liz Browning.
And can you tell us a little bit more about your shoes? Yeah, so last year when the cross-country team qualified for Nike Nationals, this was one of the gifts that we got just for being one of the qualifying teams. Every person there got a pair of Dunks.
Oh, that's so cool. Who am I here with?
Kevin Hollinger Jr., Malachi Buckner,
Garong Bull.
And can you guys all tell us a little bit about your shoes?
Yeezy foam runners on. Yeezy slides.
I got Yeezy slides.
I love it. Thanks, guys. Who am I here with?
Officer Locke.
And can you tell us about your shoes?
Absolutely. These are very limited edition. A brand you've probably never heard of. These are called Skechers. From a very exclusive retailer called Academy Sports. So I don't know if you've ever heard of those, but they're very, very exclusive.
Thank you. Who am I here with?
Fiona Perry, and I'm wearing UGG slippers, and I got them for my birthday, and they are my favorite pair of shoes because they're so comfortable.
I love them. Thank you. Who am I here with?
Andy Falcon.
And can you tell us a little bit more about your shoes?
Oh, sure. These are the Air Jordan 10 Orlandos, which dropped, I believe, in 2018 is when I got them through the Nike Sneakers app.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Who am I here with?
Dylan Wyman.
And can you tell us a little bit about your shoes?
I have Dunk SBs on. I got them from StockX. They're the N7s in red. So.
I like them. Who am I here with?
I'm Zach Connett.
And can you tell us about your shoes?
Yeah, so these shoes, honestly, I'm not sure where they're from. I stole them from my dad, but he has good taste, so.
Cool. Thank you. Who am I here with?
Mrs. Craig.
And can you tell us a little bit about your shoes?
So these are the Lost and Founds, and for me, these are a holy grail, and that just means that there's a pair that you absolutely love, and when there's an opportunity to get, you get them. So I have an interesting story about how I got them. So there's another teacher here, Mr. Falcon, and he's also a sneakerhead, and so we talked about it, and he actually hit on these for me, and I didn't. I have zero luck on, I shouldn't say zero, but it's really bad luck on sneakers. So he hit, and I was like, are you sure? Because these are fire. And he said yes, so that's how I got them.
Well, I love them. Thank you.
Yep.
The students at West have some great style.
I agree. Well, that's all for this week's episode for OWEB TV.
We can't wait to see you around this year.
We hope everyone has a great weekend and enjoyed our first official episode this year at the Dub.
Stay tuned for next week's episode. See you then.
Bye, owls.